I had some questions about Nick Foles. This is obviously his percentage, attempts, completions, interceptions, and the years they were done, as well as what team they played. He played was playing for at the time. 2012, 2013, I think, was his actually best seasons, and that is early in his career. He has bounced around quite a bit. As his years kind of went through, we began to see that his percentage and everything started dropping off. But his yards per throw started off really good. And I believe his best year was like a 9 yards per attempt. And then it dropped. And I believe it stayed right around 7 for the longest time. Like here it shows. 6.4 to 9.1. So in 2013, he had his best season. But everything's in there. But it also dropped in percentage. So his percentage per pass, for his passes, really dropped. Now, we really don't know what he's like this year because Colts hadn't had him play. But when he played for the Eagles, I think that was absolutely his best 2 seasons of his career. His interceptions started going up. His completion percentage started coming down. His touchdowns started coming down. But there was a question asked by a viewer, and he wanted to know why we haven't put Nick Foles in. And it's a good question. But I wanted to answer in some kind of statistic way, be able to show where I think is the reason why. I think it's just because he has fallen and as he's gotten older. And I personally was never a Nick Foles fan. I really wasn't. I just don't think he's consistent. At least, and then the numbers kind of show it. And please pause and kind of go through the numbers as they scroll across. Rewind, pause, do whatever you gotta do, but I believe that since he's left the Eagles, he really just has not had a good season. Not consistently throughout the season either, as far as throwing touchdowns versus interceptions. But, comment, let me know, say, hey, you're wrong. I don't mind. And I'll comment back. And if you point out something, if I miss something, but as well as I'm going to put down at the end of this video, it's going to be a video of Alec Pierce, I believe, is one of the better rookies. He's not been as consistent as I expect him to be. But anyways, kind of on a side note, all that, he did an interview. And the interview really shows that he's trying to be honest in it. I think he got very uncomfortable with one of the questions. I think it was the first question. But he actually kind of followed through with a good answer. And I think he's taking some true criticism. And he's saying, yeah, I do need to do better with this situation. So, anyhow, at the end of the video, you guys have a good one. Like, subscribe, hit the bell. I will go live eventually. Just don't know where that's going to be. You all have a good one. And if you do enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up.
Good. We know why the Colts drafted you. They loved your ability down the field. That's sort of come and gone and come this season. But how would you evaluate yourself on the other parts of your game? You're developing the entire route tree, winning those contested catches over the middle. That seems to be a little bit inconsistent this year. Good in spots, not so good in others.
Yeah, I think inconsistent is a good word for it. You know, I think I need to become better at being consistent. I think I definitely flashed that I can do it in spurts, but I need to, you know, make it a more consistent thing where I can be someone that they trust in and want to give them those tough throws and have them be able to win one-on-one and, you know, get open and move the chains.
Is there like a certain aspect of that? I mean, getting off press coverage, winning when the ball's in the air, like, is there one thing you and Reggie are focused on?
Yeah, it's at the top of my routes, just like, you know, my coming out of my breaks, being clean at the top of my routes. That's probably the biggest thing.
Steven Holder.
Hey, Alec. I was just talking to Parks about this. Matt Ryan, this is probably not going to be the most memorable year of his career, right? It's been up and down, but I'm wondering your first exposure to him this year. How has he, if at all, helped you develop this year? And what has, you know, what has it been like playing with him? You know, at the a player of that experience level, how's that helped you? I guess
I think it's been great for my confidence. He's always been, you know, kind of in my corner, been very positive with me, willing to work with me, letting me know, like, you know, what he likes that I'm doing, what he thinks I need to change and improve on. So he's been a great asset for me in my career, I believe, you know, and someone that is just great to come in and learn from.
And you know, when there are setbacks, you know, like the other night, I mean, you know, yeah, he's had a bunch of turnovers late in that game. What's his demeanor like in those moments when things go poorly? Is he the same? I don't know. What do you observe?
Yeah, he generally, I'd say, does a really good job of keeping his composure. He definitely, you know, knows when to get on us and can feel, you know, when the game is. But, like, he was getting us going that whole fourth quarter, telling us, you know, keep going. Like, whatever the score was, he said, we just got to get a score here. We'll be right back in it. So he's still trying to, you know, motivate us and lead us through when things kind of weren't going our way.
James Boyd.
Alec, just out of curiosity, what does a rookie bye week look like? Especially, I guess, since the game's kind of late in the season, throughout a crazy season. I don't know if you predicted it would go like this. So what did it look like for you?
Yeah, for me, you know, I had a chance to go in, you know, I stuck around Indy a few days, kind of had to get some things done, you know, get some treatment, all that. But then I had the chance this weekend to go out east. My little brother plays basketball at Princeton, so I went and caught one of his games, and just, you know, he's a freshman there, so just check in, see how he's living, meet all his friends, all that, see the campus, and then I went to, like, New York City for a day or two before that, so it was pretty cool.
Princeton, he's smart.
Yeah, smart guy.
Charge your phone.